two, three, funk it.
Hi, my name is Makassi, and we're here to talk about jackets today. So fellas, it's spring now, you know, a little bit more windy. We can finally bring out our jackets, our knitwear, and you know, us fellas that aren't the skinniest of guys, you know, we can hide a little bit of ourselves, you know, gotta do a little bit of catfishing with the layers, you know, like women can do with their makeup, why not us, you know? Hashtag equality for men. So I love fall. Personally, fall is like my favorite season, and fall is also a good season to remind all the single people that they're lonely. And you know, us relationship people, we're gonna enjoy the good weather with our significant other.
Girlfriend's in Germany, right?
Shut up, dude. Don't listen to that guy. Anyway, let's get back to the video. Okay, so I was actually considering showing you guys more than three jackets, but I already know this video is gonna be like 10-20 minutes long. Honestly, I should really be making 3-7 minutes of video, like, to truly capture all of your TikTok influence brain, where like, if a video is longer than 1 minute, your brain does like a deep exhale and just like, it's like constantly searching for like a new thing that will give you the gratification a lot faster than like a 20 minute video. So I should be making shorter video. I'm trying to cut more things, but I want it to be natural. I don't want it to sound too fake with the script and the research and all that. I want it to be as natural as I can be. All right, so the first thing that we have for you today is it's the Hydra Acumen Bomber Jacket. So I haven't worn this jacket in like 2 to 3 years now. Alright, back to the jacket. So this jacket was from spring summer 2018. So the bomber jacket itself wasn't on the runway, however this jacket was, and it's a really nice colorway. It's a really nice turquoise, but I personally like it better when it's reverse, and this jacket is reversible, as you can see. I think Hyder should have made the black side the main side rather than the opposite, like the flashy turquoise, the white lines along the sleeves and the body. I mean, look, it's really clean to me. It doesn't get any better than this. And the name of this jacket is called the Hyder Ackerman Kunzite Bomber Jacket. So as my balls become longer, meaning I'm getting older, I don't know why I had to make that sexual. Anyway, I continue to grow out of love with the fundamental values of like a bomber jacket. I see bomber jacket as like something between formality and informality, like it's somewhere in between. And I don't like that. There's this like freeing feelings when you dress like shit on purpose, and then the shit outfit that you wore on purpose is still better than rave outfits. I mean, good lord. Look at all these Kevin Nguyen and their ugly outfits when they go to raves. I don't understand. This is such a disgusting behavior, like, they all need an intervention. But anyway, bomber jacket is like halfway between these two things. It's like, let's put that in football terms. It's like the Dallas Cowboys. It's like, it's not great, but it's not shit either, so it's stuck in mediocrity. Anyway, just like the extra long sleeve, the bomber neck detail, the cinch waist, like these are all traits of like a bomber jacket that I'm like a bit iffy on. Like it changes for me every week. Like some weeks I really enjoy it, some weeks I'm like, eh, that's really bad. I'd rather wear my formal jacket. Anyway, the pockets. So the pockets, they sit very high, which makes for like an interesting shape when you put your arms in the pockets. And I'm sure you're looking at the B-roll right now. I think it looks really good. I think it's just like, it's subtle, but it's different. And the material is 85% rayons, 13% cotton, and 2% polyester. It feels like silk, soft. However, if you look here, after a few wears from like 2-3 years ago, you can see that's like, there's like this pulling effect on the material. Like it's a bit messy. I'm sure you're looking at the B-roll right now, so I don't know how to describe it, but I hope you can see it. And another thing is like, because due to the cinch waist, like I tend to wear these with like my wide-legged trousers, something on the wider side instead of skinny or straight, because it makes for a much more interesting outfit, because like it's very flowy at the bottom because of the wide-legged trousers, and then it cinches off with the waist, and then it's cropped on the body, so it's very like 1/3, 2/3 type of outfit. And if I were to wear skinny jeans with these, I would just look like every other guy who shops at Urban Outfitter. Do you know what I mean? Like just skinny jeans, logo tee, big chunky shoes or Doc Marten, and then obviously the bomber jacket with the yellow, I mean not the yellow, with the orange interior. It's super basic to me if I were to do it like that. But yeah, so these retail for about $1,700. It's a bit pricey. However, it's kind of like expected from like a big fashion house, or not like a big fashion house, from like a high fashion house. So like Hyder and the team, they position themselves among like the upper echelon of the group. Like the price is not justifiable at all. However, you're not just buying the product, you're buying the prestige that comes with wearing Hydro Acumen. Overall, I really like Hydro's work. It's really fun. Like a lot of experiment with different materials that you can see with this jacket. 85% whatever, 13% whatever, and just like, it feels like silk, however it's not silk. Like it's just the way he plays around with like the structure or construction of the garment is also very interesting. Like it's subtly different that like mainly only the wearer knows. Like the pockets detail, you're not gonna know that if you don't look for it, and if you're the wearer, you will notice it. Yeah, so I prefer to wear it with the black on the outside because, you know, on the inside I'm black. Alright, so I will admit I am not the most knowledgeable when it comes to Ander Milimeester. I understand that the New Guards group has acquired them, and the New Guards has like control like Palm Angel, Off-White, whatever, Antonioli. Like it's a big conglomerate, or a try to be conglomerate. They're growing, but so I don't know too much, and at the moment I know that they don't have like a singular creative director. It's more like a team, and I know that they are consulting with Anne and her husband. In our closets, we need a nice button-up, we need a good pair of like cowboy boots, we need a good pair of derby, we need a nice plain black jacket with like traditional collar, and that is what this jacket is to me. It's a simple jacket, but a very well-made one. You're not gonna get a lot of looks when you wear this, like it's not a statement piece. Just a plain black jacket. However, when you look deeper, that's when you see all the details. That's what makes this jacket subtly different than every other black jacket. Look at this video right now. Do you see it? Let's go in closer. Do you see the subtle shapes when you get up close to the material? I think that's really cool. It's just like something only the wearer noticed. I think it's really cool rather than just like a straight black line. So it's a nice interesting shape. It just something extra there, you know, it's amenities. It's not the main thing, it's like the topping of a cake. It's good, but it's not gonna kill it if it's not good, you know. But anyway, so the main reason why I love this jacket is the collared. I love this type of collared. It's just traditional collared, and I think I like this collared more so than like a bomber collar because it feels more sophisticated, it feels more classic, it feels more timeless, whereas like the bomber jacket is a very trendy type of neck, and it's just like sometimes you like it, sometimes you don't. Some year it's in, some year it's not. And another thing that you notice is that the arms, they're very long and they're a bit bigger than normal. Like it really swallows up the arms. The reason why the left sleeve was fucked up was because while I was taking a final, the professor was really like paranoid about people cheating. So like he moved people around, so he moved me. But I had one of those rolling chairs that was more comfortable, so I didn't want to give that chair up. So I just rolled that chair back up to my new seat, but then I didn't realize my jacket was caught underneath, and then it just... it's a bit fucked up, but I will get it fixed soon, but I kind of don't want to because like every time I look at the fucked up sleeve, I think like of that day. I think of that day where I finished the final in like 10 minutes, so it was fun. I got an A in that class. It was fun. So what I typically wear with these is that, okay, for some reason, I don't know why, for some reason, I always wear these with my tabbies. Whenever I pick up this jacket or whenever I know that like tomorrow I'm gonna wear this jacket, I always gravitate towards my tabby's boots over any other thing. I tend to wear this with all black, so like wide-legged black trousers, very flowy polyester, a simple black or white Uniqlo t-shirt, the tabby boots, and this jacket. It's simple, it's classic, like you don't have to stress about these. This jacket isn't a statement piece, so your pants or your footwear, they can be your statement piece instead. However, instead of doing all that, instead of having an outfit with a statement piece, you can just have a very cohesive outfit where it's just all black. It kind of blends in as one. Like nothing stands out, but it goes so well. It's very cohesive. I said that way too many times. Let's keep going. This jacket right here, it's gonna get a lot of wear this season. I love this jacket. I brought it to Europe with me. I went to New York with it. It's such a lovely, lovely piece. I love wearing it so much. Although I love wearing black garments, there are a few exceptions in my wardrobes, like my banana trousers, my omplissé, like it's a lot of colorful thing, and then this jacket and maybe a few knitwear, like this one. I really, really love Bodhi as a brand. However, they're very pricey, so I don't have as many pieces as I would like to. Bodhi jacket would retail for $500. I would honestly have a 20 Bodhi jacket right now. And you know, so Bodhi doesn't go on sale that often. Even if they do, only the bad stuff goes on sale. And if they do go on sale, like, it's like 10-20%, and like, they sell out so quickly. Like, Bodhi jackets, they sell out at retail, which is crazy to me. But you know, Bodhi has a lot of crazy fans. All right, so material, it is 100% cotton. It feels a bit rough, like these old vintage quilted bed sheets that you find at your grandma's house, because it is. It was sourced in New England from like the 1930s, so they just source the material and then remake it into this jacket. Classic collar, I love this collar. This collar and the Anna Milanesi collar, my favorite. The bomber jacket, sometimes I like it, sometimes I don't. And another thing that's different with this jacket than the Anna Milanesi, this is more boxy, so like it's a lot wider, and the sleeves and the body is like, it's the same length. Whereas the Anna Milanesi jacket, the sleeves are a bit longer. Three pockets, two at the bottom, one at the boob. Very useful. And on the pocket on the boob side, there's also a button so like you can clip it for more security. And it is made in India. No, not India according to Columbus. Actual India. So let's flip the jacket inside out real quick, because I want to show you the stitching of it, which I'm not too big a fan of. Like, you can see that the big quilted pattern is just like stitched onto the main body, and it wasn't stitched on too well. Like, it's not consistent, it overlaps, it underlaps, like all of these crazy things. And one of the quilts on the arm is already falling apart. Hopefully you're seeing it right now, but I'm gonna have to stitch that back up, or I'll ask my mom to do it or my partner to do it. I just wish it was more secure than what it is right now. And it is polyester feeling, so there's a little weight to it and a little warmth to it, which means that it's not the greatest for summer. It's more like a fall jacket, a spring or a winter. You know, in the winter time, just put a hoodie underneath, put a knitwear underneath, and you're all good to go. Yeah, so once again, it's $1,500, and it's a bit steep, but they're a small brand, you know. It's an upcycling piece, a lot of manpower to source these, a lot of mending, a lot of fixing to the material before assembling them into material, marketing, production, photography, wholesale, etc., etc. Just, they're a small company, so the price is a bit justifiable, but I'm not a fan of it. So this is a size extra large, / extra extra large. I am 170 pounds, I am 5'10", and I normally wear a size large, and honestly it fits oversized enough for me to like it. However, I believe I can fit the medium to large and the large to extra large. Measurement, so let's hope I have done like some cool animation or something cool to show you the measurement here. I'll say it out anyway. So the length is 26 inches, the shoulder is 20 inches, the chest is 22 inches, the sleeve length is 26. Stitching, not the greatest on this garment, because the tags, when it first came to me, it was four stitches, and now there's only two, because I'm just wearing it and I'm not wearing it that aggressively, and the tag is already like falling apart. So please, Emily, the team, reinforce these hoes. And as far as wearing these, I have a very simple closet. I wear a lot of black trousers. Always gonna be black trousers with me, so then I don't have to think about it. This jacket is already like a statement piece, so like you don't need to have another statement piece when you're wearing this. Just let this stand out on its own. Awesome.